You cannot live without civil engineering. You drive on the pavement, on the highway bridges every day, and you live in your house, and you go to a school building, and you go to a hospital, your doctor's office. So everything is built by civil engineers.
I was always interested in why roads were laid out a certain way.
I took after my mother, who had extremely good mechanical ability.
I like built things, so that's why I chose civil engineering.
I learned to work on cars, learned to use my hands, fascinated by mechanical things, and so it was just assumed I'd be an engineer.
The Master of Science online degree has a history about 15, 20 years, and this is one of the oldest master online programs in the United States.
What gets me really excited about it is dealing with a diverse student body, people with a wide range of backgrounds from different cultures.
I've had students from Australia, South America, Japan, Iraq, Iran, Afghanistan. I actually had a student from the Azores Islands, and I had to get out a globe and try to figure out where that was.
The online courses will provide civil engineers who probably will work on the job site very often a good, great opportunity to update their knowledge, to advance their skills, and also to help them to practice better in their daily job.
We've got top flight faculty. They are setting the standards of practice, usually in their fields, in a wide dispersion of field. We have people that are some of the top 5 to 10 people in the country, if not the world, in their area of expertise, and you will learn from them on how to do things right in your profession.
The courses that we offer, a lot of them are unique. You can't find it in other programs in civil engineering. For example, we have wetland design, and that you don't find in other programs. And we also have timber design and masonry design that you don't find in the traditional structural engineering program.
We try to expose our students as best we can to a realistic environment so that they understand the expectations, not just the technical expectations.
I want them to walk out and be prepared for those professional examinations that they have to go through as part of our career.
So I think civil engineering, this is not you get your degree and then you're done. It's a lifelong learning process.